Hey everyone, Mr. Happy here, and welcome to Final Fantasy XIV Versus. This is a series we do occasionally comparing the pros and cons of jobs within a role to determine which one might be right for you. While I will declare the job I think is best in the role for the given patch for this video, this should not discourage people from playing and enjoying the other jobs mentioned. For this Versus, we're going to take a look at a role I play a lot, Ranged Physical DPS. This role is made up of three jobs, Bard, Machinist, and Dancer. Now, for sake of avoiding redundancy, you won't hear me mention ranged role actions for these jobs since all three jobs share them and thus benefit from them equally. Let's start with the original ranged physical DPS, Bard. This bow-wielding instrumentalist is adept at providing a variety of buffs to party members while dishing out its own DPS. It rotates between three songs, Mage's Ballad, Army's Paean, and Wanderer's Minuet. These all provide the party with some form of DPS buff while also altering the bard's own skills in some way. Ballad provides a 1% bonus damage to any nearby party members, while having your damage over time skills occasionally reset their Bloodletter and Reign of Death skills cooldowns. Army's Paean provides 3% direct hit to nearby party members and grants a stacking haste buff to the bard occasionally when those dots tick. This buff persists for 10 seconds after activating your next song, with the efficiency varying based on how many stacks you had when you left Army's Paean. Finally is Wanderer's Minuet, which provides 2% crit to nearby allies and grants the bard pitch perfect stacks occasionally on those dot ticks again. Up to 3 pitch perfect stacks can be stored and used to execute your pitch perfect action, dealing a huge burst of damage off the global cooldown. This is considered Bard's most powerful burst damage song, and thus, you align your personal and raid buffs alongside Wanderer's Minuet whenever possible. This includes Raging Strikes, which outright increases your damage dealt for a short time, and Barrage, which not only causes your next single target weapon skill to hit 3 times, but also allows you to use Refulgent Arrow. You'll always use Barrage on Refulgent Arrow. For their DPS, bards mostly focus on keeping their two dots up, refreshing them with Iron Jaws whenever necessary. As you've gathered, your dots interact constantly with your songs, so them not being on a target is bad news. They also interact with the bard's soul gauge at level 80. This gauge fills up, gradually empowering your Apex Arrow attack. At 100 gauge, it's recommended to immediately unleash your Apex Arrow for massive damage as your next global cooldown skill. It's important to note, Apex Arrow is AoE. Barrage does not work on it. Like we said, you'll always use Barrage on Refulgent Arrow. Between all of that, Bard also has plenty of other damage skills to upkeep on single targets. Burst Shot is what you'll spam when you really have nothing else to do, with it occasionally proccing Straight Shot so you can use that Refulgent Arrow skill we mentioned earlier for more damage. As for your off-global cooldown skills, Bloodletter will be your most used skill, especially during Mage's Ballad. As we mentioned earlier, it gets reset when your dots tick occasionally during that song, so you use it a lot. Sidewinder is used during burst windows and deals bonus damage if both of your dots are on the target, further increasing their importance. Finally, Imperial Arrow deals a bit of damage, but automatically procs whatever song effect you are currently benefiting from. So in Ballad, that's a Bloodletter proc, in Paean, that's a haste buff stack, and in Minuet, that is a pitch perfect stack. You'll want to be using this very, very often. That's only single target too. Bard gets some pretty nutty AoE if you set it up properly. Reign of Death is the AoE equivalent of Bloodletter, and shares a cooldown with it. So if you're constantly getting resets during Ballad, it's really fun, and it's very potent. You can also get Reign of Death resets with your go-to AoE weapon skill, Quick Knock, so even outside of Ballad, you can get some extra AoE damage in, and during Ballad, you'll have more of these than you know what to do with. It's a conal AoE on Quick Knock, though, so you gotta kinda line it up properly. You also have Shadow Bite, which is an AoE equivalent of Sidewinder and also shares a cooldown with it. Just make sure you use Shadow Bite on a target that has your dots on it for maximum damage. Bard is pretty much stacked in any situation DPS-wise, you just gotta keep those dots up. On top of that, Bard still has more utility. We already mentioned the rotating songs, but they have more on top of that. Battle Voice provides nearby party members with 20% bonus direct hit rate, so long as you have a song active. Nature's Min can be placed on a single player to increase their healing received by 20%. Wanderer's Paean can be used to cleanse debuffs off a single player, and Troubadour reduces party damage taken by 10%. That last one is actually shared across all three jobs in the video, though with different names. Regardless, it stacks up quite nicely with all the rest of the things Bard can do. So the pros of the Bard are pretty well-rounded. It's got solid single target, solid AoE damage. It especially shines on exactly two target AoEs, since it can use Iron Jaws to keep its dots rolling on both targets, which also greatly increases the number of song procs you get. It has an immense amount of all-around utility, from healing, to cleansing, to damage reduction, to bonus damage. It's all really small individually, but it just makes the job really flexible and satisfying. Of course, the job also has great mobility, but that could kind of be said about all three of the ranged physical jobs. I'd say Bard is in the middle of the other two mobility-wise, at least thanks to its repelling shot. Its cons, on the flip side, are few and far between and mostly come down to personal preference or opinion. For one, a lot of the party buffs don't actually affect the Bard themselves. They don't get the damage buff from the rotating songs, nor the direct hit buff from Battle Voice. It doesn't affect their performance, but just think of how much better it would be if those things did affect the Bard themselves. As for the actual gameplay, some might find the job's constant song upkeep, ability resets, dot management, random procs, they might find all that to be a bit overwhelming if you haven't played it before. It can certainly be a lot for players to manage all of that and do boss mechanics correctly. This can also make the job somewhat unfriendly to players with high latency, as you have to do a lot of double weaving or using two off globals between a single global to react to procs constantly. It's also very luck dependent for a job. While you can force procs with Imperial Arrow, and the 40% chance of those dots proccing a song effect are pretty high, that doesn't change the occasional disappointment in how few procs you get. Also, speaking of procs, Apex Arrow, your job's level 80 skill, its ultimate ability is kinda meh. I mean, it's not bad. It's 600 potency at 100 gauge, and it's an AoE in a line. But it just kind of feels like it's just there to press occasionally. It just doesn't mesh with the rest of the job, or so I feel personally. So the job has some pretty high highs and some reasonably low lows, but it's an overall strong job choice in this role and a strong contender to start the video with. Next up, we'll talk about Machinist. This job was introduced in Heavensward and was entirely reworked for the Shadowbringers expansion, so ignore any other versus video I've done before this. It feels almost entirely like a new job. The Machinist combines its guns and various gadgets to dish out the most damage of all three of the jobs in this video. Between massive single target hits to machine gunning skills out during short burst windows, it's a fun fast choice for anyone looking to forego all that fancy utility you had to worry about on Bard in favor of straight up damage. Machinist's two main mechanics are heat and battery gauges. Upon using certain weapon skills, these two gauges fill up and allow you to activate other skills. Your heat gauge is used to activate Hypercharge, a short buff that gives you access to Heat Blast for single targeting and Auto Crossbow for AoEing. They have a short 1.5 second global cooldown, so you can pump out 5 of these rapidly in the duration of a single Hypercharge. Heat Blast also lowers the cooldown on your Gauss Round and Ricochet attacks, two off global cooldown skills that deal some more damage. You pretty much just pump out one for each heat blast, so that's 10 quick shots in about 8 seconds. Your battery gauge, on the other hand, is used to activate your Automaton Queen, a robot that will lock on and assault your target. After rapidly punching the enemy, it will fire off a pile bunker for massive damage before retreating. You can trigger the pile bunker manually early if a target might die beforehand or fly away and become untargetable. You don't want to lose that pile bunker. Now, between those two gauges, you do have other skills to work with, obviously. A basic three-part combo is your go-to for charging heat and battery gauge. Drill is a big damage hit you get every 20 seconds, and Air Anchor not only does massive damage, just like Drill, but generates 20 battery gauge on top of it. Using these skills on cooldown makes for the bare basics of the job, only deviating for AoEs and hypercharge windows. Speaking of hypercharge, your most important use of this is to charge up your wildfire damage. Once every 2 minutes, you can place a time bomb on an enemy that, upon detonating, deals damage based on the number of weapon skills you hit it with. That means, ideally, the 5 heat blasts you get during a hypercharge window, plus one other weapon skill on the tail end for a total of 6, and then bam, wildfire explodes. It can also be detonated early for the same reasons you can detonate Pile Bunker earlier with the Automaton. A few notes about Wildfire. It specifically works with weapon skills, which are the abilities that sit on your global cooldown, or Heat Blast, which just has a much faster global cooldown. It is not enhanced by things like your Gauss Round or your Ricochet. It's also not enhanced by your Automaton Queen's weapon skills, which, while they are classified as weapon skills, do not count from the Machinist themselves. So you only care about that 6 weapon skill window we mentioned earlier. Machinist does have some AoE skills as well. Spreadshot is a basic AoE, much like Quick Knock from Bard, that generates some heat. Auto Crossbow we mentioned earlier, and it's just the hypercharged equivalent of Spreadshot with a much faster global cooldown. You also have Bio Blaster, which places a dot on every target hit. This shares a cooldown with Drill, so you usually sub out Drill for Bio Blaster on AoEs. Finally, you have Flamethrower, which deals 100 potency every second for 10 seconds in a cone in front of you, so long as you hold the channel. That means no moving or otherwise canceling the skill. There's actually some math that supports this skill being pretty finicky to optimize on, as it doesn't generate any heat or battery gauge. Despite that, I like to press it in dungeons to AoE while I drink my coffee. It's my coffee button. As mentioned earlier, Machinist is a low utility job, only having Tactician, which is the same as Bard's Troubadour. This means the rest of its skills just support its DPS needs and not the party. Reassemble makes the next weapon skill critical direct hit automatically, so you use that on Drill or Air Anchor only. It unfortunately does not work on the dot portion of Bio Blaster or Flamethrower, so on AoEs you can use it on Spreadshot or Auto Crossbow, which have the same potency, so those are your only two choices really. And finally, Barrel Stabilizer instantly grants 50 heat, so it's a free hypercharge every couple of minutes. So the pros of the Machinist are fewer than Bard, mostly because the job lacks utility. It is indeed the highest personal DPS of the 3 jobs in this video, so anyone looking for a higher damage option will want this one. It's also very fast-paced for those who just want a faster-paced job. Bard was fast too, and we didn't really pronounce that too much other than labeling it as a con, but Machinist is just fast in a super satisfying way, without a whole lot of fluff. Despite the speed, it also has surprisingly few buttons, so it's also easier to manage in regards of available key bindings. It has no dots to maintain, which can be a relief to some, and finally, while it is technically the least mobile of the 3 range physical jobs since it doesn't have any sort of in-combat movement ability, it's still really mobile. As for the cons, there's a mix of them. For one, it's lack of utility we've mentioned a lot, but you know, you've heard that by now. Also, despite the lack of utility, as of this patch, it's of my opinion that its personal damage is still not quite high enough. I'd like to see some additional buffs in future patches. Its AoE is also pretty underwhelming. It's not bad per se, but between having no AoE means of generating battery gauge, to auto crossbow not resetting your ricochet cooldowns, to flamethrower being kind of poor to optimize, it just feels kind of meh, especially on 2 targets where Bard was so strong. Machinist practically doesn't use any of its AoE weapon skills on 2 targets except Bio Blaster if Drill isn't being reassembled, so there's that. But the biggest con is that this job is very unfriendly to those with high ping. And this could be a problem on Bard, but here, it's a downright showstopper for a lot of people. This is mostly due to the interaction between Heat Blast, Gauss Round, and Ricochet. Since it's ideal to weave one of these between each Heat Blast, any significant latency can cause you to clip your global cooldown and just outright lose Heat Blast if your latency is bad enough, if you're trying to do the base rotation. Fortunately, there are alternatives to this where you do less weaving to make sure you don't at least lose a Heat Blast, but it still feels really bad to see a low latency player play the job the way you just wish you could at times. If you can overcome these cons though, Machinist is one of my personal favorite jobs in the game to play, and the rework has overall been pretty great, even if I still think it needs a few buffs. Finally, we come to the latest addition to the ranged physical role, Dancer. Much like Bard, this is a high utility DPS that provides tons of bonus damage to the party, along with some other tricks up its sleeve. Its 2 primary tools are standard and technical steps. Activating these will start a dance, to which the player plays a quick game of Simon Says before activating the finished dance. This finisher not only deals amazing damage, but provides a damage buff based on the accuracy of your little minigame. Standard finish provides 5% damage to the dancer at its maximum potency, as well as their dance partner, whom you can select before the battle and basically give them a permanent 5% damage buff for the whole fight. Technical Finish provides 5% damage to the whole party for a short time, so long as they are in range of the effect. These are the dancer's two hardest hitting skills and essential damage buffs for the rest of the party. Using these skills almost on cooldown is a basic one should get accustomed to, only adjusting based on individual fight needs. The job's gauges, on the other hand, mostly interact with the dancer's personal DPS. Dancer has two basic single target and AoE weapon skill combos. Upon using any of these four total weapon skills, you can randomly activate a flourished version of each of them to be used independent of your combos. Activating the flourished version of the skill not only deals more damage, but has a 50% chance to grant the dancer a fourfold feather. This can then be used to activate one of two off-global cooldown skills, Fan Dance 1 for single target and Fan Dance 2 for point-blank AoE. Activating either of these fan dances then has another 50% chance to grant you a flourished fan dance, which allows you to activate the off-global cooldown skill Fan Dance 3, dealing AoE damage on the target. Yeah, tracking and using all these procs is pretty essential to Dancer, and I know it sounds confusing, but it's very intuitive once you actually get into it. Your Flourish skill, a skill actually called Flourish in this case, helps with this a lot, as it grants you one of every flourished skill instantly once per minute, giving you plenty of chances to generate feathers, deal extra damage, and even a free Fan Dance 3. They also earn Esprit starting at level 76. This is another resource on your job gauge. This can be generated by the dancer or any party member benefiting from standard or technical finish. 50 Esprit allows the dancer to activate Saber Dance, a powerful AoE attack. Using these Saber Dances during burst windows or before overcapping on Esprit is very important, so keep an eye on that resource. With that, the rest of the job is utility. I already mentioned the damage buffs from standard and technical step. I also mentioned you getting to pick a dance partner before the fight, and how your standard step buff applies to them as well. Now, there are two other skills your dance partner also benefits from. Curing Waltz heals in a small AoE around both the dancer and their partner. If both players are stacked up, both heals will hit everyone in the AoE, so this acts as a pretty great healing cooldown once a minute. It's like a free indom from a scholar coming from your DPS. Your partner is more likely to be excited about Devilment though, which boosts the dancer and their partner's crit and direct hit rates by 20%. Time for some big damage. Dancer's other two utilities are good, but a bit less exciting. Shield Samba is the same as Troubadour and Tactician, while Improvisation is just kinda awkward. It's a channel dance that grants nearby allies bonus healing while also generating Esprit for the dancer. Sounds pretty good. It's fine and all, but the amount of Esprit generated by Improvisation scales with the number of people in range of its effect. At a full 8 people, it generates 10 Esprit a tick, which is great. But any less than that, and it generates one less Esprit per person missing. It's really awkward when you have like 57 or 24 Esprit, and is probably the most disappointing part about the job. It can still be utilized during downtime or if the whole party is stacked for a boss mechanic, but the finicky nature of it really clashes with the otherwise flowing nature of the job. Oh, speaking of flowing nature, Enivant, its movement skill, best movement skill in the game. A fixed distance dash that charges up to 3 uses. So good. So pros for our final job here. Dancer is a very simple job to play, even if a lot of it is based on luck. Very few overall skills, straightforward priority systems, it's just easy to play. Not to mention Enivant again, which grants them insane mobility far above pretty much every other job in the game, not to mention just the roles in this video. It is also incredibly satisfying to play, especially when you get those big crit direct hit dances. Its AoE feels really good, especially since this is the only ranged physical DPS whose AoE isn't Conal, which I hate jobs with Conal AoEs, I'm sorry. It makes it very easy to hit everything. Finally, its utility is Boss, permanent 5% damage buff to an ally, occasionally granting them critical and direct hit buffs, damage reduction, and a heal. On top of that, the 5% damage buff from technical step to the whole party once every 2 minutes. Listen, the improv buff could use some work, but you can quick activate and deactivate it for 5 seconds of bonus healing, get a tick of Esprit, and you know what? It's fine. Oh, and no dots, so again, reinforcing the easy to play part. The job does come with some pretty straightforward cons though. While it's easy to play, the luck-based aspects can be pretty frustrating, very similarly to Bard. Not to mention with so few DPS skills, if you don't get procs, at times it's almost boring, I want to say. High highs and low lows. Its overall efficiency in content is also highly dependent on having good party members, more so than most other jobs in the game other than Bard. If your dance partner dies, it's less overall DPS, less Esprit, and less fun. Also, optimizing on the job can be a little bit weird, mostly because of Saber Dance. Strong as the ability is, it's kind of disconnected from the rest of their rotation. Finally, improv. It's fine, it's okay, but come on, just fix the whole less than 10 Esprit thing, please. If none of that bothers you though, welcome to the Clan of Dancers. It's my favorite job to play and my main job in raids. Now that covers all three ranged physical jobs in patch 5.11. Hopefully they don't change anything in 5.15 and then I have to remake this video. But who wins the actual versus? This is a competition in a way. As much as I'd like to give it to my best boy dancer, I think Bard's the winner for this category. While it can be a bit hectic, it's just so damn good at the same time. In pretty much any situation, all the cons we labeled were down to personal preference or opinion. Some of the other ones are, but all of my Bard ones were opinionated and were based on my own personal judgment. I do think that Dancer takes second place, but only because Machinist, I feel, just doesn't do enough DPS to warrant its lack of utility. This is a problem Black Mage and Samurai suffered from in the past, but don't really suffer from right now. Hopefully they nail this down in 5.15 or 5.2. Heck, I think the whole role could probably use a little bit of a bump, but as they are now, they're at least holding steady. And that's going to be a wrap for my first versus of Shadowbringers. We are, of course, going to be doing versus for the casters, the tanks, the healers, and the melee DPS, and we will be updating them throughout the expansion as balance changes are made, so please keep an eye out for those in the future. Thank you for watching. Be sure to like, favorite, subscribe, and share, and stay tuned for more content on the channel. I will see you all in the next one, and until then, take care.